Welcome to Raikurku.com. In this video, we'll discuss and explore the powerful world of GUI programming with Python using Tkinter library. We'll be walking you through the process of creating a basic Notepad application, something that can be both educational and practical. So without further delay, let's dive right into it. So here I've already created the code. Let me run this code, and once the execution will be completed, I will show you how we can build this code from scratch. Now, if you can see, whenever I execute this code, I can see exactly similar type of Notepad application launched. Here we have multiple options like new, open, save, exit, which we can edit it at any point of time in Python Tkinter code. Now here I will get the options to write this as Notepad. So exactly similarly, we can build it using Tkinter library. For building this, just right click on this, select new, and then select Python file. Here we have to add the file name and then get it started. I've already created. Here we have to first import the library. So this library will help us use other attributes. Import Tkinter STK, this library I've already defined. And then finally, for Tkinter import, file dialog and message box will be required. So these two library is most required to start with this code. And then finally, we wanted to add this step. And this we are just copying and pasting it here, so that we'll have the proper methods in place. So normally, what's the definitions of using this? So we are defining the class called Notepad app, and then which will represent our Notepad applications in the constructor init. We initialize the main window, title it as Notepad app, and create a text wizard for users to input their text. So here, let me copy it till here so that I can explain you better way. Now you can see self.root, and we have used title as Notepad app, and next options we are giving the root to write the text, and this text we are packing in expand and row and fill both. So this will give the options to write within that space. Next actions I wanted to define as create menu. So the menu which we have seen, new and other, we can create it through this option. Now we can see here, moving on to create menu using the menu widget which we have used here. And this menu widget includes options like new, open, save, which you might increase it. And the options link to respective functions. So if we are creating any menu option, that we have to link with respective functions, otherwise it will not work. Let me explain you each of the concept in detail. Here we have defined create menu self and the menu bar. This menu bar will help us to provide the options of menu. And then finally the config. So in config menu equal to menu bar, this config we are defining here as a part of label. So here we are trying to add the label as new, and then command self new file. So whenever we'll click on new, this will open a new file. This option is opening existing file. And finally, we are giving functions for save. So if we are using the options, normally we have to define each of the functions in detail. So let's see how we have defined these functions. So again, I'm copying till here. Now, next actions, we are defining new file. So whenever I will click new option, this should launch text widget delete existing one, and it will open the new. And this is the definition of new file, where several operations will be performed. So here When we are opening the file types, text file should be mandatory and all files which contains any name. So this is the asterisk where we are defining the wildcards. Normally this is ucon as a wildcard, and this by using this we can open any file name which should have .txt. And if file path we are calling as file path r and as file, and finally text wizard delete and insert the new file. Whenever we are selecting save file, again this will have the file path which will save the file with a format .txt or extension name with the txt and file types with this proper name. So this is how we can build the save file path. And finally we are creating tk.tk instance. So here we will specify if name main, then this should have proper. So this, if this main, then root tk.tk and finally notepad app root, and we are adding main loop. There here we have completed the final loop. Once I will save this and run this code, we will have the exact output which we have seen. Now you can see these options open, new, open, save and exist. This is how we can build any Notepad applications with Python Tkinter library. So we have completed the process how we can build Python Tkinter library. If you have any queries and questions, please let me know. So let's recap this. So we have started with class Notepad and then define the complete title and their package. Finally, we have created four menu options, and these menu options will call individual functions. So this is how we have built this complete Notepad using Python Tkinter library. This is just a glimpse of what UI programming can offer. The ability to create user-friendly applications with minimal effort. If you have enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more exciting programming content. If you have any questions or queries, suggestions, feel free to drop them in the comment below. Thanks for watching and happy coding.